The 2022 amendment of the Parliamentary Pensions Act shows former speakers of parliament who had been left out by the Parliamentary Pensions Act of 2011 brought in the bracket of beneficiaries of both monetary and non-monetary retirement benefits. Today, former speakers of the House, including Professor Edward Rugumayo, Francis Butajira, Alhaj Moses Chigongo, and Edward Chiwanuka Sekandi, have received their chauffeur-driven vehicles from parliament as their retirement benefits. The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, has revealed that Parliament will be giving the former speakers new cars every 5 years, and Parliamentary Commission will incur the cost of fuel, maintenance, and pay salaries for these drivers.
These cars remain property of Government of Uganda. Parliament will maintain these cars. Parliament will give you the former speakers, the drivers. Parliament will fuel these cars. But Parliament, after every 5 years, will be giving you a new car. Or in between, when a car gets a problem, you will bring back and we give you another car. You are property of Government of Uganda.
While handing over the new wheels to the former speakers, Among applauded them for their remarkable contribution to the country.
I want to, first of all, inform our elders that you mean a lot to us. And will continuously, as a 11th Parliament, need your wise counsel. Feel free when you want to come over. When you see that there is something wrong that we are doing that needs to be corrected, we are always open to any advice.
Among further applauded members of parliament who supported amendments in the Pensions Act to facilitate former speakers and challenged former parliaments which did not see value in honoring former leaders. Meanwhile, the former Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, did not show up to receive her Land Cruiser VXR.
I want to thank the members of parliament who felt and thought it wise that we must appreciate you, because we've had other parliaments. We had a parliament of Honorable Sekandi. They never remembered all the other people. But now we have remembered you, Honorable Sekandi.
According to the Parliamentary Pension Act, a retired speaker is entitled to a monthly allowance equivalent to 60% of the monthly salary of the sitting Speaker of Parliament. On top of that, he or she is entitled to a 1-4-wheel chauffeur-driven car with a cubic capacity of 3,500 to 4,000, to security guards, to domestic staff, medical care for the retired speaker and the spouse or spouses, and an allowance equivalent to 33 currency points per month for utilities.
We want to appreciate you, Right Honorable Speaker, for what you have said. Rightly went through the history and you found some speakers were not covered by the benefits which were extended, and you vigorously pursued it, because I was following the deliberations in Parliament.
However, there are scenarios where some people are entitled to multiple pensions, like Edward Chiwanuka Sekandi, who served in another big capacity of vice presidency. Mululi Mokasa, the Minister of Public Service, says they are in the process of amending the law to cure this anomaly.
The idea now is streamlined. You get a facility from one source, not multiple, sources.
So that is in the law?
That is what we are going to look at. And actually, those are the standing orders.
According to the Commission of Parliament, Solomon Silwine, each of the six vehicles costs Parliament 700 million shillings to bring the total cost of the procurement to 4.2 billion shillings. People entitled to these cars include President Museveni, Chairman of ANRC from 1896 to 1996, Edward Rugumayo, Speaker, and Chairman NCC from 1979 to 1980, Francis Butajira, 1980 to 1985, Alhaj Moses Chigongo, the Vice Chairman NRC from 1986 to 1996, Edward Sekandi from 1998 to 2001 as a Deputy Speaker and Speaker of the 7th and 8th Parliament, and Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, the Speaker of the 9th and 10th Parliament. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.